Approximately 4,000 women every year die from cervical cancer. They die from a disease that is totally 100% preventable. We know that HPV infects almost all women, especially by the time that they're 50. Most women now are diagnosed with atypical cells, so they may not necessarily have developed cervical cancer, but they may have the initial startings of very unusual or atypical cells, which can lead to cervical cancer. HPV causes more than just cervical cancer. It can be associated with anal cancers and anal warts. We've seen a higher incidence of head and neck carcinomas that are directly related to HPV infections. The current recommendation is that any woman who's having her pap smear over the age of 30 be screened not only for the pap, which is looking specifically for cervical cancer, but included in that an HPV, or human papillomavirus, screen. HPV, or human papillomavirus vaccine, was partially developed by our local physicians and scientists here at IU School of Medicine. The goal is to start this in all children at the age of 9. You want to give this vaccine before a patient has ever come in contact or been exposed to the virus. That means giving it to kids long before they ever think about being sexually active. Research that is ongoing about human papillomavirus is fabulous. You know, perhaps we don't have to do a three-part series for the vaccine. If we only have to give it once, how much easier will that be for folks? How is it transmitted? We know that for the majority of cases, HPV, especially that related to the genital area, is related through intercourse and through sexual activity. But because it's a skin virus, there may be other mechanisms of transmission that we're not really quite aware yet. We have to protect our community, we have to protect our children, and we need to make our Hoosiers healthier and happier and leading productive lives.